And does it help in couples when they're more clear about the, what they want? Because I know one thing I hear or from people all the time is that, you know, I'll hear something from the wife and then I'll hear something else from the husband. And I'm like, you guys need to get together and tell each other what you want from each other, you know?
Yeah, that's some of the work that I do with the coaching. It's just like basic training in communication, how to communicate. Right. And just, you know, raw honesty, like being really honest about what's happening for you, what we're afraid of, what we want or don't want. I mean, we tend to hold that stuff back because we're afraid of being rejected or, you know, scaring the other person off. And what we actually wind up causing is the thing we're afraid of, because the more you hold back, you know, communication is relationship. Those are synonymous. If you're not communicating, you're not relating. Just remember that. If you're not communicating, and if you're not communicating, you're not relating, then you're actually separating from this other person. So that thing you're withholding is what damages the relationship. Even if it's something you think is unkind or not nice, you know, it's better to share it than to hold it back. Because what we hold back will destroy us, right? So.
Yeah.
I just want to get clear about one thing, too. It just popped into my head earlier. You know, this works regardless of what type of relationship it is. Great, gay, straight, whatever type of relationship. You know, no, it doesn't matter. You're either masculine essence or feminine essence. And this works the same way, no matter what type of relationship it is.
So what's the advantage? I mean, let's get down to the nitty-gritty here. You know, you're working with relationships, and I know you work with careers and all over the place, but the bottom line is getting people in touch with who they are, their authenticity, their masculine, feminine thing. And when you do that and people start uplifting themselves and having more communication, better relationships, I mean, I could see a lot of advantages, but I want you to tell me, what's the benefit? Like, what do we get to... what do we get to have on the planet when people start stepping back into this?
Yeah, great. Thank you for that question. I think it's about love, right? It's about having more love on the planet. What makes us happy is when we're loving, not just feeling love, but giving love, because love is the creative force, right? So you start in your individual relationships, in your family, and then in these smaller communities, and like the bricks in the house, those smaller communities build the greater community. So with each one of those communities becoming more open, more receptive, more creative, right? Using both forces, masculine and feminine, we sort of create this greater container, right? We become more receptive as a whole to creative source, right? So source can spill into us and we get to bring forward something greater on the planet, right? More creative, more loving, you know, not as destructive. Right now there are some really destructive things happening in general on the planet. So not that that's necessarily bad. Sometimes there needs to be a breakdown before a breakthrough, but we're ready for a breakthrough, right? We're ready for more communion, more intimate connection with each other. That's really what's trying to happen all the time. But something much greater is going to come forward, something more authentic, more whole, more complete. I don't really know what it looks like. I can only feel into it, you know, and it feels to me like passion and love and joy, you know, just unbridled joy.
And it feels like, you know, I love this word, unconditional love, you know, where there really are no conditions. It's just about loving. Love. And of course, it starts with finding out who we are and loving ourselves. You know, don't you think that's where a lot of this begins, is figuring out who we are, what we want, and loving and accepting who we are before we could really start moving forward? And
yeah, I think so. I think it's happening at the same time, you know, because we're all really joined, we're all really one, right? So the person in front of you is representing some aspect of you. If you can love what you don't think looks so good over here, you're actually loving that part of yourself here, right? So it's happening at the same time, right? So you're loving yourself and you're loving the person in front of you, and that's the power of intimate relationship, right? Romantic, that's why I think romantic relationships, that's the biggest game on the planet, right? Romantic relationship, that... a lot can happen if we transform how we relate to each other romantically in these deep, loving, sexual, intimate relationships. It automatically transforms the world to do that, right? Automatically.
And so I know people have talked to me about this masculine, feminine thing, and I never really got it in the same way that you're explaining it. So I love that. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
It's so clear to me now.
Yeah. For at least a few minutes.
A few minutes anyway. It comes and it goes.
Like, it's a challenge to be in the middle of all of it. I'm in the middle of it myself in a relationship situation. So, and I'm challenged to keep loving even when it doesn't feel good, even when my heart's in pain, is to not withdraw.
Just keep moving forward.
Keep moving forward. Keep giving love. Right.
Cool. It seems like this is perfect timing. You know, I think it's time for everybody to open up their heart and for everybody to move forward a little bit and bring out the masculine and the feminine.
Yeah.
Let it be easy and joyful. I mean, it's supposed to be easy and it's supposed to be joyful. So it's great to go out and seek help. I mean, there's people like Mark or Power Coach that can, you know, that can help you. And there's people, I know Mark's in Pennsylvania, but can you do sessions or can you do over the phone? Do you do phone sessions as well?
Most of my coaching work is over the phone with, you know, single people, with couples. I do group work as well. So, yep.
And so if you want to get more information from Mark, you can go to his website, which is www.corepowercoach.com. And I'll go ahead and spell that across the bottom of the screen. corepowercoach.com. And I'm assuming that on the website they can contact you either through email or your phone number.
Yeah, you can click on contact me and it'll take you to my email, or there's a phone number on there as well.
Cool. It's time for all of us to open up our hearts and move forward. So it's time for all of us to step into the masculine and the feminine.
Yes.
And just do what we came here to do, and that is connect. You know, really connect. And I know that's what people want more than anything, is to really connect. So if you want to connect and open up your heart and move forward at the same time, work on your relationships with yourself, your relationships with your spouse, even in groups. So yeah, A+, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Mitch.
And yeah, it was so great meeting you, Mark. You
know, pleasure to be here.
And it was great. Thanks so much for the hike today, too. Are you enjoying Santa Fe, by the way?
I am. There's a lack of oxygen here, but other than that, I'm doing well.
I know, we're going for a hike. I always forget when I take people for a hike that are from sea level, and I'm like talking away and walking up the mountain, and they're like, I can't breathe. But you did really well.
Yeah, such a beautiful town.
Yeah, it is. You picked a beautiful time of the year to come here, too. And so thank you all for joining the show today, and I hope you got some great information on how to uplift yourself and how to really improve and enhance your relationships with each other and really feel connected and open up your hearts. It's a really good thing. So thanks again, Mark.
Okay.
And you all have a great evening and Merry Christmas.
It's
Christmas in a couple of days, so I hope you all have a really Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And thanks again for joining us at Mind Over Matter TV. And if you want to reach me, you can go to our website, which is www.itsyourmindthatmatters.com. Or you can reach me at my email, which is mitchfriedman1@gmail.com. And again, thanks again. Blessings and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas, boys and girls!
Here comes Santa Claus! Here comes Santa Claus! Right down Santa Claus Lane!
He'll come around when the chimes ring out, then it's Christmas morn again.